Well, of course, good morning to you wherever you may find yourself. My name is Sammy Ofosini. The show is The Ultimate Sports here on HS Television. Of course, yesterday was a very bad news for the Black Meteors. I don't know what's happening, but of course, we'll try and dissect into those matters, as Dennis Moore will put it. But let me just run you through the very synopsis of my show. Of course, we begin with what happened yesterday, that debacle where Ghana couldn't beat Algeria. So our qualification to the Olympics sort of in tatters. I'll introduce my guest very soon, and we'll talk about that. Of course, we'll also be talking extensively, yes, about the upcoming matches which are going to take place in Europe. Of course, if you have time, probably we'll delve a bit into what happened last week with the European leagues now not in session because of the international break. Of course, we have a big personality. Yes, today is a boxer who is going to fight for the WBO world title. Yes, you heard me right. WBO world title. Talking about Patrick Allotey. Yes, Patrick Allotey. They call him the Sweet Arrow. I will ask him why the Sweet Arrow. That's very interesting. So it's a packed show that I can promise you. There's a lot more as well, which will be revealing as and when the show progresses. My name again is Sammy Ofosunhene. You can join me on this this platform. You know, my show is always much more interactive. So again, join me on 0244 30 64 26. That's for WhatsApp, because during the dying embers of the show, I'll probably introduce not just my guests, but also introduce phone-in calls so that you guys will equally also get a feel of it. Probably ask Patrick Allotey some questions here and there. But right about now, let me just introduce to you my guest before I go for a quick commercial. But sitting next to me is a man who needs no introduction. He's also a co-host. You watch him mostly on Monday evening, also represented with Ultimate Sports. His name, Dennis Oblogo Moore, spotted in Boxing Ghana. Atta, you know,
thanks very much.
Was all the way from Choice FM, so you know that Dennis is he's been there for a long time. Of course, he also represents Ghana Cycling, and he's also the head of sports here at HS Television. So he's a big man.
Sammy, thanks
he's
very much man. For the compliments.
He's anyway. A big man. Sitting next to him is a man who needs no introduction. You know, I always say that if you don't know this man, probably you don't know much about Ghana sports. Yes, it's a fact. You know, Sammy writes about every sport. Sometimes I wonder how he's able to manage all that, because there are certain sporting discipline that if you ask me, I'm sure I'll fumble. But Sammy makes sure it keeps going. Of course, Sammy Haywood Okan, the general. There's a reason why they call him general. The general of Ghana sports. Very much welcome to the studio. He also writes for Boxing Ghana. And of course, Boxing Ghana's editor is Dennis Moore. The associated this guy, editor is Sammy Haywood Okan. So they are spotted in Boxing Ghana.
Manager editor.
Okay, so it's great to have you guys in studio anyway.
Great man.
It's a pleasure.
It's a nice weekend, you know. But let me say, very, very sad one. So, I mean, even just to take the win out of your sales, you know, I was very, very sad yesterday. I was at Accra Sports Stadium, and I watched the game between the Meteors and Algeria. And I think with all intents and purposes, I think the second leg on Tuesday is really going to be a cliffhanger for Team Ghana, from what I saw. I'm very, very sad up to now.
Okay, so you see, Dennis Moore is even eager to kickstart the whole thing. Of course, you can also join us on 0244 30 64 26. WhatsApp only, I beg you. I'll open the lines later, I beg you. Just WhatsApp and SMS. But, Sammy...
You know, I'm the best attaché to 2020.
Oh, really?
Yeah, the Olympic Games.
The Olympic...
So, if you go with football, you know, football can also get the fans going. Football fans can join and will go. But if there's no football... And I don't think there'll be football, because this the next leg will be very, very difficult for Ghana. Against Algeria.
But the women
forget that Algeria will go. Mm. But Algeria are the African champions, current African champions.
Oh, okay.
So I don't think the
But I mean, before this particular match, you were very confident. You were telling the players to look out for and
all that. I know our boys are good. But Charlie, ego, they feel too big. You see, they feel too big. I don't know. And the demeanor of the coach too was very poor. The coach, I was standing on the bench talking to the boys. He says, you know, there was no wind, there was no power, you know, and the boys didn't play well at all. Algeria scored first. We had 2 penalties before we equalized 1 goal. Mm. It's not good at all. And we should know if you go there, they'll give them 3 penalties or 2. We should know it.
It's a fact, I mean.
We should know it. You just wait and see. You know it. And you see it. You see, so in fact, unless it's a miracle, let us qualify. And after beating Algeria, if you can beat them, go to the tournament in Egypt. There, 3 teams are going to Tokyo. Wow. So it's not an easy route at all. Yeah.
Wow. But let's try to understand.
Our league is not on. They were not playing any local matches. Now call them. Now call them.
So let's try and understand the problem. I mean, the genesis of this whole thing. Look, I heard from certain quarters that they were not really like remunerated very well. They didn't have enough time to even train. And even some of them had to buy their own tickets and all that.
That's what we
heard.
How
true is that?
That's what we heard. Later, the ministry, whatever they release, that it's not true that they should buy their own tickets and come. But do fair for everything, do fun for everything. And see, I can see there's no motivation in the team. There's no motivation. And the Olympic Games is a very important tournament. It's a very important game that we must go with football. You know, Ghana is a football nation. Mm. But now other countries are taking over. Look at Mali, Senegal. Look at how they structure their football, especially their youth football. And if there's no youth, there's no game. Mm. And right now, our future is very bleak. Ghana football future. All of those people say it's bright, but it's not bright. I don't think it's bright. Because our youth football or our junior football is not there. Mm. And if it's not there, the future is not there.
Wow. that's very, very interesting. But let me bring Dennis more in. Dennis, you, I don't know how well you've been following this team, but did it came to you as a shock, the fact that they were not able to beat Algeria? Or was it always coming?
Well, Sammy, I think, as I told you earlier, I was at the stadium yesterday, and because that game was so, I mean, of so much importance to me. You know, Tokyo 2020, you know, is there for everyone to, because from next year, you know, all the environment is really going to be aromatic of Tokyo, Japan 2020. And clearly, you know, this for me was to be the beginning of Ghana's quest to be at the Tokyo Games. You know, but clearly from what I saw, it actually leaves much to be desired. And clearly, all the players that I actually saw on the pitch, you know, were players, I mean, of nice repute, and but they actually didn't live up to expectation, you know, on paper. A player like Yaboua, who actually was touted, you know, as a player, I mean, on the field on that day, you know, failed to glitter. And there were many a times when he got to the, you know, the final third, you know, the 18-yard area, Yaboua would actually lose consciousness, on how to even kick the ball, you know. But clearly, the Algerians were more tactical. I spoke to a few guys after the game, Ali Jara, and of course, you know, and some of the guys, my colleague media guys, Moshosho, of Asempa FM and all that, clearly, they were all very much disappointed, you know, at the games. And clearly, for me, the second leg on Tuesday is much crucial. You know, as we speak now, today is Saturday, right? Mm. They are supposed to leave tomorrow. Tomorrow is Sunday.
Leave to Algeria.
To Algeria, yeah. On Sunday.
For the return encounter.
Exactly. If they're not able to leave tomorrow and they go on Monday, are they going to get the needed rest to play on Tuesday? Trust me, they're also going to play under floodlight, you know. And look at how
AstroTurf.
Now, you see, these Maghrebians are dangerous when it comes to tactics. These same Algerians have been, you know, our nemesis since time immemorial. You remember the Slemson episode in Algeria? They actually caused us, we couldn't go to the World Cup and all that. And Ali Jara was telling me that since 86, 93, these same Algerians have been our major obstacle on the road. And yesterday, it's also manifested. So, what is the way forward? Now, talking about what really transpired before the game yesterday, with regards to their remuneration, air ticket stuff, and all that. So, I mean, I have never seen anything like that. But if it is true, you know, then I think that, just like Sammy said, who is to be blamed? Mm. We blame ourselves.
Sammy, who is to be blamed? I mean, you are
it. Ourselves. And those who blame, they know themselves.
They know themselves. Excellent.
Yeah.
They know themselves.
See. Why you don't do a good work, you should know it.
Absolutely.
Don't do a good work.
You know.
But don't to be paid. But they're not doing the work.
Exactly.
Who are these guys?
Authorities. They're not authorities.
No, yeah, they're human beings. I mean, they're human beings. You know, we want to qualify for Japan. Mm. And trust me, let me tell you. Mm. The Japanese.
About planning. If you don't plan well,
the Japanese authority, the Japanese enclave, are more eager to see this game, to see Ghana qualify.
Yeah.
They want to see Ghana there. Mm. Look, last year, His Excellency, you know, Ambassador Himeno, called the likes of Osei Kofi, Kofi Pare, and other likes to the embassy. To see them, for them to showcase what they won in Japan 1963 or thereabout. So they are eager to meet Ghana again in Japan. Look at what we are doing. We are not actually attaching so much seriousness to, this particular game. See, the whole picture is like, look, after Egypt, it's okay. I mean, we are done. Forget about these people. It's so sad. Mm. It's so sad. Yesterday, look, Ali Jara told me that, look, the Algerians are more tactical than the Ghanaians. It's a fact. Mm. They are tactically strong, better than the Ghanaians. Now at the post match conference, Sammy was saying, look, and if this is to be on record, then we are already dead. They said when we come there, they will surely get three penalties.
because the official say they post press that they were cheated. The two penalties were not clear penalties, you know. So when you get there, they do their own thing.
Their own thing.
And they are in North Africa.
Absolutely.
If you are playing North Africa, it's very easy.
They've been doing this since time immemorial.
So that's what they do fall down.
Yes, they fall down.
That's what they do fall down. They waste time.
Sami, even yesterday.
It's a little one goal.
Even, Sami, yesterday. Yesterday, even, I think some 15 minutes to the end of the game, look at what their goalkeeper was doing.
Yeah, yeah.
When the ball goes over,
it's a great
he will just walk into the tunnel to go and pick the ball.
Yeah, meanwhile, there's a ball on the pitch.
Meanwhile, there's a ball on the pitch. Sami, it was amazing. You know, many people were, at a point in time, people were throwing objects from the VIP stand onto Coach Tanko.
Oh, really? Oh,
I'm telling you. But it actually attracted the attention of the security guys over to quickly arrest the guy. So, I mean, it tells you how Ghana actually saw the game yesterday. It was simply pathetic, Sami.
Interesting. And even, attendance was poor.
Mm.
Those who came to watch the match, I can count them.
Wow. They charged 5 Ghana cedis.
5 Ghana. If nobody was going, nobody was interested in Ghana football. Why? That's why we jumped to boxing. That's why some of us later we went to boxing and let's set the boxes. And we have 10 champions and we've got more champions. Today, because Maguey is fighting. Mm. And next week, Alto is fighting.
Yeah.
More champions will come into boxing and we've got more 100 champions in boxing, like the Mexicans.
Mm.
Yeah, that's why. So, governments must know where to put the money.
Mm. In privacy, boxing. Exactly.
Yeah, and athletics and other sports, not only football. Look at people went to Egypt. Even the fans were there, whilst the Ghana has been taken out and the fans were there. Is it good planning? Wow. It's about planning and preparation. If you don't plan, when you fail, it's about planning. If you have visionary leaders, you also have vision. Who can think far? Who can think 5 years, 10 years, 15 years?
Hmm.
You know, look, even football, like Jalen said, after Egypt, they think everything is over. But others are coming, other generations are coming.
Exactly.
Some will be 20 years, some will be 1 year today, some will be 10 years today. Others are coming up. So what about them?
Hmm.
If this generation didn't do well, or this group didn't do well, what about the 2021 others coming up.
Absolutely.
The others coming up. So share them.
And you know,
whatever that we are going on.
Absolutely.
Yeah, you
know,
going.
Just even add to Sami's submissions. Look, this team is supposed to be the cracks of the next Black Stars, isn't it?
Mm.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
So what we saw was totally, you know, shambolic in this.
That means you can't qualify for the next World Cup.
Absolutely. You know, yeah, because I mean virtually the team.
Kota.
I mean, I don't get the players. And look, they were very sluggish in attack. When they get a ball from their own end and they're moving, they look sluggish. Meanwhile, they were down by a goal to nothing. And it was so amazing, you know, to see them play. I can't believe what I saw yesterday. I mean, so what are we going to do in Japan?
Okay, so your messages are coming thick and fast. It's interesting though, but of course I'll read them on the bounce. But Sami, so talk because of what's been happening, I don't even know what to say. How is the GOC preparing for the Tokyo 2020?
You know, it's the football people, GFA, we are just there, when they qualify, we'll take them, then we'll take over. So let them qualify. It's for the football people, the ministry. So whatever they need, or whatever they want that will qualify, help them to get it. You see, then we'll qualify, fine, then we'll go. But the Jews, we are for all the sports, you know, every discipline, we'll qualify. We have athletics, handball, rugby, even Paralympic. I like the Paralympic too, they'll qualify and go for the Paralympic Games. Yeah, they are doing well, but as we talk very deep about them.
Mm.
You see,
okay. So this one is saying that I believe Ghana is going to win in Algeria by 2-2.
Somebody believe.
This is Benedict inside Awutu break. Benedict, that's the confidence. Anyway, that's
miracle.
Good.
It's a miracle.
Okay, so this one is saying that this team there, you can't go anywhere. They were just shambolic on the day. Okay. So keep your message coming on 02-44-30-64-26. And there is 1-2 from Lydia Fosua who says that, well, I still struggle to know how the team is selected.
Uh-huh.
Okay. But Sami, let me come to you. Yes, I don't want us to divert a bit because I know that there's a lot happening. Some of the athletic department are equally doing very well. I know about cycling. I know about some few things where we got medals and stuff.
No, boxing. Even boxing. Mm. I had this African Games.
Mm.
It was supposed to be a qualifier to the Olympic Games, but there was a problem there about the weights. So they didn't use it as a qualifier.
Okay.
So lucky for Ghana, we'll go for another qualifier in Senegal. That's next year, February, for the qualifiers to the Olympic Games in boxing. Mm. So with boxing, they couldn't do very well, you know, in Morocco.
Mm.
We got 21 silver there.
Okay.
But you saw the game. You saw some of the clips in Morocco.
Mm.
They were cheating and, you know, not fair judgment and things.
Okay.
You see, some of our boxers did very, very well, but we were robbed.
Okay. So now we are going to talk about the GFA Congress.
Yeah.
It was very interesting. I don't know, but I'll start with Dennis Moore. First of all, somebody will say the biggest hurdle has been cleared. Now what next?
Yeah, so I mean, I think, first of all, I need to give kudos to, you know, the five-man committee, you know, set up, you know, by the football body, I mean, their own football people, you know, standing the work of the NC. You know, what the football people did, you know, using some few days, the NC had been there for over, you know, 1 year. And that actually tells me that the football people really need to be given their chance to take up, you know, their own mantle and do what, I mean, they actually need to do. But one, until Fianco, I didn't see him there yesterday. Was he there around? You know, I came and a bit late.
No.
You know, these are the problems that I really want us to, you know, just veer off. Yeah. Let's come back to football. But, you know, if the NC tries to set up some agenda, for example, that if you are caught in the announce tape, don't step there and all that. You know, you are incurring the wrath, you know, of the football people. Do you understand? These are the, I mean, the same people who has inducted anybody. Nobody. Yeah, you understand? True. Yeah. So, look, we shouldn't clamp things so much tight. But, you know, in some, it was a very nice program, and I'm so much happy, you know, for the front of football in Ghana. And for once, I've actually also seen so many people in line for the presidency. And we do hope, you know, that when they also do come to power, what we saw for the past times wouldn't actually replicate itself. But clearly, from the list that I'm seeing, you know, the names that I'm actually seeing, I saw my guy Sedu Ademo, you know, going around bringing some names around, Sedu, wherever you are, you know. But you know, these are credible names that some of you and I know. So I wouldn't want to mention names because I also have my own favorite, you know. So. I do believe that, you know.
Please don't call me on the line. I'll open the lines, but kindly don't call me on this line. This is for just SMS and, I mean, normal SMS and, of course, WhatsApp. Please don't call me on this line. I'll open the lines in, I mean, sometime. Don't worry. I'll tell you when the time comes.
Good.
So, but, I mean, let me ask you. Let's try and zoom in.
We have set 27th October as a day for the elections.
Okay.
Yes.
Yes. But, I mean, if you give me
but let's do something. Okay. I'll come to you in a bit. Sami, I've seen so far 6 candidates, okay, out of the 6. Just profile them for me and who you think has the better chance of winning.
We have Palma.
Yes.
Palma, Wilfred Kuku Palma of Tema Youth. I think it's not bad. It's not bad. We also have Fred Papu, who is my cousin, a football person. I can't get Olympics, Bobo. He too is not bad. Ketukuku is a friend. Dreams FC. It too. I can say they are all not bad, but I can hear there are two others coming on board, want to join the race. I think the Kotoko chairman, Dr. Chi, and another person.
Kwame.
Yeah. We also have Nanayao. I spoke to him. He's a very nice guy, cool guy, very humble.
But I mean, you forgot to mention one name that is on my heart so much. You forgot to mention that name. But you mentioned only 3 names and
Jaffi.
Exactly. And you intentionally dropped that name.
Okay. So,
you know, George, I can say George is the incumbent or the current chairman or the president. If you go to FIFA, his name is there as Ghana president. So he's the one who has the most chance, I can say.
Yeah. George.
He has the most chance.
George.
Jaffi.
Yeah.
Okay. He's a leading contender.
Okay.
Yeah. And others like Palma, Kez, Pepapu,
Strong opposition.
And I can say this guy too has fans, but
okay, cool.
No.
Randy.
When he came there, so he has five good fans, positive fans. But he's not going. Yeah, and I can say maybe you support Papu or I don't know, but in my mind I can think
on this platform, probably say next week and next 2 weeks, we are going to support a candidate. Yes, we are going to support a candidate. We're going to support a candidate.
Okay.
All of us here.
But in supporting a candidate, is it going to be an individual support or a group support?
It's going to be a group support.
No.
And we're going to tell the candidates that this and this.
Yeah. But I mean, I think you need to start to bring one of them, of course, in
this. Oh, yeah.
I've made arrangements to that effect.
Okay, so we'll be coming.
We'll bring all of them here. Yeah. Definitely, yeah. We'll decide.
You know, HSTV is leading right now.
Oh yeah, of course.
Yeah, HSTV.
Of course, in terms of viewership, everything.
People like HSTV.
Yes, of course, our stood guys here in studio. Why won't we lead? Please don't call me on the line. Like I told you earlier, it's for SMS and WhatsApp solely. So, first of all, can we say that now all the so-called problems with the GFA and everything is now over, and that now we can look up to the elections on October?
Well, Sammy, I think it's 90% over, because there could be a few scraps, you know, to be dealt with, you know, especially, you know, the leftovers of Alhaji Grunse's statement that he made about the Gorobo Boys thing, you know, which actually caught up with so many of the media and all that. But clearly, we all know Alhaji Grunse, you know, and of course, you know, his utterances, but he actually apologized, you know.
Yes, Goro Boys, eh?
Goro Boys,
was
zero.
But I mean, see, in a case of, I mean, Congress, I mean, like this, you know, you need to spice up Congress. So, you know, Grunse, I like
you think that was what he was doing?
Come on. They are all football people, you know, and if the guy immediately just come over to apologize, just move on in life. But I don't think, if Alhaji Grunse also has an aspiration to become a president, this, I mean, shouldn't be a stumbling block, you know, I mean, to Grunse. You know, yes, basically.
One of my problems was the representations. Like, a whole schools and colleges, they have only one slot. You know, schools and colleges, who got a thousand of schools in Ghana.
It's crucial.
And the colleges.
So, Sammy,
which one of the investors, right?
They have their tertiary.
Tertiary, okay. So
they have one slot. But look at schools and colleges. That's why our football is going down.
Okay.
Is it also not weird that the clubs, all of them have a vote?
The Premier clubs, they are too big. They are 1-1-1-1.
Yes, because they have football
for them. Football is not for the Premier clubs.
Exactly.
Football is for everybody.
Sure.
Could have Gota, Big Soccer, Foster. It's not football. And all the Premier clubs, they feel everything for them. It's not good. Schools and colleges, that's what we store, schools and colleges. So we don't play inter-co, we don't play inter-schools even at the lowest level, basic.
So you have a problem
that's
with
the composition. That's why we see the talents.
You have a problem with the composition. Is that not the case?
No, if they agree, they know best because they are there.
No,
so they say they don't need one slot. If FIFA wanted the composition to be to come down.
To come down, okay.
Yeah, so they came to 120. That the
composition of the
Congress will be 120.
Okay.
Yeah, it was 123.
123.
Yeah, they made the 120.
But you see, coming to this, you know, whole thing once again, I do believe that moving forward, you know, the FA should rather think about the development of football in its entirety, rather than, you know, getting personal scores, you know, getting personal ambitions in the game. You can see that, look at the caliber of people who were, you know, at Congress. It tells you that, look, Ghana has interest, in such a sport. So you see, the development of court football was for me very, very paramount.
Yeah.
On that day.
Oh, wow.
But so exactly. So if you just like Sammy is saying, if you have to give just one representation for schools and colleges, what are you talking about? That means you are even crippling, you know, the main agenda for the promotion of football in our schools and colleges. Which is a very
P is dead.
P is dead.
You don't even know about P.
I have PE teachers in some of these colleges who called me after they said, Dennis, you guys, I said, well, this is a football issue.
P.
You know, so Sammy, the more you are represented, the more you can have a say. It's like parliament. Go to parliament if you are able to. If you are very outspoken, you are able to get it.
My producer says you used to be a PE teacher. Is that why?
Exactly. Well, by the way, that was way back in training college. Anyway, but so you see, moving forward in that stance, I believe that now I'm so happy for them once again, Sammy. And in fact, I really loved the way they all came together as one people to see that look, football is our game. Let's make it hours. And when, in effect, on the 7th, the elections is done, and whoever wins, football is back again.
The 7th or 27th?
Is it
27th?
Yeah, sorry, 27th, okay? And it's going to be a very big day for Ghana football, you know, so that we can actually see the way forward to see how Ghana can really harness the lost, you know, effect in Ghana football for now. Now, Ghana football, everybody will tell you, is dead. Frankly speaking,
it's
dead.
But I was even thinking if the team up, you see, maybe they are about six. Maybe if this one will join this one, it will come together, you know, and create more unity, and we'll fight together. But everybody wants to be the boss. Everybody wants to be the boss.
Exactly. See, now, you know. Nyantechi is gone. So maybe Nyantechi 2, maybe we'll come over and then we see who...
Nyantechi 2. And that one, we already calling some few people here and there. Okay, so that's great. Right. But Sammy, we want to bring a closure to this GFA story. But what I want to know from you is, what were the things that was changed from the GFA, this whole conference day? What were the... I was told some few articles were amended and all that. Can you just walk us through quick?
You know, what I liked about the conference is that some of them stood their grounds. When they changed the name of the boss to the chairman, they said, no, the one president. Okay. They want to change to CEO. Mm. They said they like general secretary. Mm. You see, okay, and yeah. I was glad with the Gophers guy.
Uh-huh.
Achi.
Oh,
Achi.
Fredachi.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
And, Champo.
I mean, Shadow. They're same. Mm. Whatever they wanted at football names are, they say it should be inserted. And they make sure they were inserted. So,
and I think, Sammy, also not to cut to you, but the tenor of office of the presidency.
Yeah, it was
also key, two terms.
Yeah,
it's fantastic terms. Now.
Mm. So but the elected members will go for three terms.
Yes.
At the ESCO.
The ESCO, exactly.
For three
exactly.
Terms.
Yeah.
But the members, the president will go for two terms.
Okay.
It's good.
It's good. It's good.
Yeah.
So, but you know, it was a good
thing. I mean, for
so
me.
Now they will look for an elected commissioner. Mm. Yesterday, I did a story on West Dankwa. So, people said he's going to be the new EC. But he called me and told me that he's not the EC. But the person should be a lawyer.
Okay.
That brings my mind to that they said the board should have a master's degree, which people talk about so much.
It's
a member of the NC now. Mm. That's quite a degree, but it's there. So you shouldn't think about any academic qualifications.
Those things are not important.
If you know ball.
Absolutely, that's all.
Football, you should know about the game.
That is why I would have loved to see Alhaji Kusa even there. You know, I mean,
oh, really?
I'm telling you. But Sammy, even before we actually leave, I'm sure you're getting prepared to.
Mm.
Now, I want to talk a bit about, you know, an event currently happening now in Ghana.
Oh, tell me about it.
And it's about the Greater Accra Cycling Competition.
Oh,
yeah, the cycling challenge is as I speak now.
If you're oblivious, he's the communications director.
I'm the secretary general of cycling. Cycling as
okay.
well.
Okay, secretary general,
yeah.
That's big.
Exactly, yeah. Mm. So it's still happening now at the Teshi, you know, municipality, where it was a three event, main event.
The finals.
Final. The first one was
Osu.
Then
they went to Adan.
Pram, Adan. And then today, it's in Teshi. Okay. So today happens with the final edition of that, you know, cycling promoted by Promacido Carbell.
What are the names, the star names that we should be looking out for?
Akufu and Ku, Akufu.
Mm. Exactly. We have the likes of Akufu. We have the likes of, you know, Isaac.
Young guy.
The Pampam guy is a different
16
guy.
Years old.
16 years old, you know.
And he's good.
And yeah, he's good. But
what's his name?
He's Allotey.
Allotey.
But you know something? You know, you can win a this race. But when the race is continuous, that is where you can see your sport. I mean, your shortfall.
Fatigue will
still fatigue. Mm. So I wouldn't say he's too much of an,
exceptional
something. No, it's one. Go ahead. Mm. But when you are actually entering into a race, 1, 2, 3, 4, about 10, 11 stages, that is where you prove your mettle. Of course, I mean, on the road.
Today is a very good day for sports. Okay. Yeah, athletics. Apart from the cycling, today we are having the Milo Marathon at the Indoor Square.
Okay.
And also in Kumasi, we have the Ghana Fastest.
Wow.
The Ghana Fastest are produced. Match for Ghana.
Exactly.
We also went to the other avenue. We saw them.
True.
Okay. And the guy who did the RM test, the second leg.
Wow.
They are by four.
Yeah.
They are running today in Kumasi.
Wow.
For Ghana Fastest.
Okay. Wow. So this is where we bring actually a closure to this particular topic that we're discussing. But of course, you know that the man himself is here. Yeah. WBO Africa champ, waterweight champ. You're talking about Patrick Allotey. We go for a quick commercial break. When we're back, of course, he's here. And we talk to him. And of course, and we open the lines as well. I'll be right back.
Close to Amasaman.
Think English language is that easy? Then please help me with the name of this spooky utensil. Thinking of Nadel? Nadel! Well, get it right once and for all. It's ladle. Yes, ladle, not ladle.
You will agree with me that English language plays a very important role in Ghana.
And this cannot be overemphasized.
Get It Right is an educated television program
that seeks to make Ghanaians more sensitive to good English through entertainment.
Get It Right will serve as a reminder of the difficulty in speaking and writing good English.
At the levels of grammar, pronunciation and vocabulary, we shall deal with the deviant forms and usage, as well as common errors in the English of some Ghanaians.
As we seek the views of the Ghanaian populace through our street twist segment.
The bandage was food around the wood.
And finally, on the sports array, fanatics will face the challenge of explaining some simple terms used in their respective sport disciplines.
As you can see, there's so much for you to get right on Get It Right.
So watch out for this exciting, thought-provoking, and educating television program coming your way.
Get It Right. Educating through.
This tuition is not just theoretical. They are so comprehensive and down-to-earth that even the slowest students will find it very easy to understand due to the visual concept of the video.
To conclude, in going down the group, you know, because we add more shells, the distance increases and it makes the nuclear attraction lower. And so it is easier to pick an electron from the atom shell. That is why we say that going down a group, ionization energy decreases. Going down a group, ionization energy decreases. Why? Because there are more shells, and therefore the effective nuclear charge on the atom shell is low. However, in the same shell, in going across a period, that one, the shell is constant. You are adding on more protons, you are adding on electrons, and so more protons are added. This increases the effective nuclear charge. We learn right videos. We teach all the concepts and theories in a very demonstrable way, with practical examples, so that we understand the concepts and also keep the pictures in your mind. We learn right, students, you are guaranteed excellent results. Learn right is established mainly because of you. With learn right lectures, man, you are covered.
And Queens, my name is Jeffrey Norte, the host for GTV.
Hi everybody, this is Dr. Sonny Badu.
My name is Ohinere Giftianti, and I want to urge you to keep on watching GTV.
The person will share GTV.
GTV,
a drop of blessing. Life, I will trust in you
alone. My name is Dr. Lawrence Tete. I recommend you to tune in to GTV.
You're very much welcome back to the show. The show is still the Ultimate Sports here on HS Television. My name still remains Samuel Fosin. Of course, like I told you and like I promised you on Facebook, on all those other platforms, I told you I was going to bring in what? Patrick Allotey. Yes, the sweet arrow. I've been wondering. I'll try and find out in the jiffy. But of course, he is the current WBO African Waterweight Champion. Yes. And we are grateful to have him. My guests are still here with me. They will be helping me do it just like we do it with a normal cliche. Yes. Yes, Patrick, you're very much welcome to the studio.
Thank you.
Sitting next to Patrick is his coach. If you don't know this man, probably you don't know much about Ghana boxing. He's actually the head coach for the Ghana boxing team. interesting enough, he was in Morocco as well, which we secured one bronze. We'll try and we could also get a gist of that. But today is just for Patrick Allotey, so that's what we'll do. That's Coach Ofori Asare. He's a great man, I tell you, man. He's a three-star. Sammy, you help me on that one.
Yeah, three-star IBA coach.
The only three-star IBA coach in Ghana, right? That's bad. Only. I'll ask Coach why we don't have somebody like him at least picking the ropes. We also do that on that one. But of course, as for these two people, I don't need to introduce them again. Patrick, first of all, you're very much welcome to HSTV.
Thank you.
It's an honor to have you in here. You're one boxer that most people have talked about the fact that you've not gotten the opportunity needed. This time, you have the opportunity to probably stake your name and actually win a world title. How does that make you feel? How does it come to you? How does that make you feel? That's what I want to know first.
Yeah, thank you. And thanks for the viewers also. You know, I'm very grateful to have this opportunity because the boxers, we are plenty, and most of the times we don't get the chance to go for the world title. So I'm grateful to have this opportunity.
Okay, that's according to Patrick. I want to, there's a lot to ask because look, where you're going is interesting. I mean, Maguire is somebody you can beat, no two ways about it. If you watch him against Hogan, nobody will tell you. But Hogan is not so special a boxer. But fact is that you are going to fight on a Mexican Independence Day, something that you don't take lightly. So definitely there will be a lot of something tilting his way. I don't want to put that in your head, but definitely you are going to have more opposition than ever. That's a fact. First of all, how does that make you feel knowing that you're going to a different country, different environment? Your supporters are not there. How have you psyched yourself, and how does that make you feel, Patrick?
Well, you know, this is not my first time traveling to Europe. Yes. I've been there before, and so I don't think for this coming one will scare me, because I've been in a crowd like where I'm going right now before, and so I don't think it will panic me or something. Yeah. The confidence, the training, everything is there. So I'm okay, because the crowd will talk. Mm. By the end, left the two of us in the ring.
In the ring. Yeah. I love that. Sammy, you shoot some coach is here. Questions must circulate throughout. So it's gonna go around like that. Sammy, it's your turn to ask your question.
I have to ask him, what is your motivation towards this fight? Because Ghana has got 10 champions. If all things is well and all things is positive and victorious, we're going to get our 11th world champion. So what is your motivation? Going in and know that these Mexicans too will be coming in their numbers, because Mexico and America is so far. So like my boss said, they'll come in their numbers. So what is your motivation? What makes you feel that you'll be the Ghana's next world champion?
Yeah, thank you, Mr. Sami. Like I said, I know they will come in their numbers, like you said, but the two of us will be in the ring. And because of that, I'm not scared about anything, because I want to be the number 11th world champion in Ghana.
Okay, so I'll go to the next one. But let me tell you, Ghanaians in Chicago are telling me that they will be coming to support you.
Wow.
Just to give you that morale, because they know that you will have hostility, so they will be coming to give you that morale. So
that's actually good to hear.
Yeah, that's nice.
But I want to speak Ghan with Patrick because if I speak Ghan, I actually give him motivation. You know. Patrick, okay. Tete.
Yeah, Drew.
Yes, good. As we speak, Ghana FM Kwebu. And this is my first time of meeting you one on one. As for Coach Lengele, your brother. Fight no ya mine, but more Olelewa.
Yeah, in Lele, in the coach, what I should work well, son, any big command if you one training, can any big command if you none of any work overcome any be any if you one call a day in there, take a work with no one your call, yeah, phone, my low left phone.
Interesting. Ghana be fair, bus money, won a new world title. In fact, there's a breaking news pony, a colleague, a male engineer, a metallic breaking, I can use it because ni wonu ni se o twi fan fi o it's about Isaac Dogbe
yeah
she bi an e won ta ni gboba no mo fan mo ke e twi habo so that when you go into that fight come we need a world title bi an who's the last world title so I mean no
Richard Comey
Comey good so mo fan mo kwabo inkwe o clips down fantastic fighter and padi unkwe le unkwe le fi o e wo mi tama bibu akeshi is your fight going to be a knockout I know kwa kwa okelebaya 12 rounds ni kwa you know mita mali mana naka mita mana miwa
yeah
12 rounds alo
I don't I'm bali boxing we train 12 rounds
sure
yeah she je we training ke anaka train 12 rounds
12 rounds okay
ni ke okwe in terms of me no more bana ke she always come up by ring me feel ready ke 12 rounds
okay
she in hana na defense
okay
I can mean win
okay
yeah no wo any animal Binda, I guess him manocle because long immaturely
good.
Yes, no, me a ring game in mafia let. Yen in no fear no. Can he get when you no more in knockout K ba? And it's an email and I can't say Balen.
Okay, wonderful. Yeah,
that's great.
Yeah, that's great.
She, she like me cry back a no 33. Are you cool down? Are you cool down?
Recording.
Yeah, recording 33 fights, no defeat. Bo yeah. Uno 40 you ni 43 no lose 3 ni bi do lose 3 mi no ka say mi akashi ko if you make mistake na go do never do this mistake and lose again mi ni o ka say akashi ko 3 then lose na go do because nka akashi ni o win e swag o na bo swag o na do yes former swag award winner
okay yeah
wo ni wa lose e do wa because wo na bro wa lose Oh, you know, I'm going to make a mistake offering do you game me. Kuni wa here so no win that lewa Ghana, cafe cafe.
You all the boxing and game lose win get draw. Wa no meet mokoni wa fe no fe no no ni ni oile. Wa no no meet mokoni wa fe ni biye no ba no ile no lose him. Kama you no go go in lose down. No one she lose be. No you fight ne. In ya can ya lose ni ina no ni ba ni ma she opponent e gbe e ja reshin e treat mummy no e treat ko me to ma no e ko me no no na no ni o ni asan ni ma ya ring game ni maka ke shin mi she le gbe agbe no won ko ko in terms of our record e ke ji oje 33 ke je mi 43 me ba na ke 10 no am I head
of
yeah
no experience
yeah no no asan ni no won ke na kan won yin chu mi koni mai ma do ma shoju ba ni ma no koni mai ma wini ya ga shin mi e more experience feel yeah e was an ma use na kan experience e wa koni no ni ta wo ni ni a she no na kan gbeke ni ma ni ma e
okay ni ma bi ga shin how has been your relationship with your management ka bi promotions wala ga shin mi meni hebo ni won mi to me I'm bored wa because last year I'm not swag best promoter of the year ni ame wa mkutu muhawisi iti ya tau bista tilei iti robiu
Globa
si indeshe eno mbele buwa miwa bubu ya watata o tumi ame bomode to some extent si bonto na amete yake si boji mema jobu tuwa miwa bubu wante how do they help you how are things training program and everything motivation and everything like I was saying
yeah you are doing kwa ame human kwenye yungpa enough you yeah and kama yonu kwe kabik promotion when I get from you on the question, I'm a banana by our Ghana boxing, but I'm a set piece. Yeah, and Gualini because promoter said P. Bana Menyan Bikumani, I'm a fate Tomabini, Kabik promotion fear. Do I come out you know, Miss Ivan Bruce Kujo, a brother, Ellis Kui, yeah, a Kabik team, if I'm a fam, I'm a boy, I'm a woman, then why? J. Mofemoni by boxing, you know, the near fear, none men I'm in fear, you. Get respect ni am ke na kan ye na kan no ni am enya am fi ke a o boxer se ko ni
if I can maybe wa maybe ko
my coach is here
e chaparu allo sweetaru like me just sweetaru mi ke chaparu she coach ke
poison
saru wo to nji mi na ro ni
which of the arrows
arrow arrow mi na ro ni
the poisonous is the
the latest the
one arrow
is the poisonous arrow
is the name okay
yes. Okay the latest but one but coach is here you guys
are coach I baba because chaparu
chaparu he loves to call me that the coach
poison
poison
arrow
from sweet to poison
okay coach what did you name him the poison arrow
Patrick Allotey has been on the Mimi Poe scene for a long. Enough for WBC International, enough for WBO, IBF, enough for all those kind of fights, federation, international federation. I'm a Belgian. One of the very good boxers, he would follow Canelo, Canaan, Islam, Kazakhstan. It was a very tough fight.
Coach, let me not catch you. There are a lot of your messages coming. I will try and read them. But of course, now you can join us via voice on 0302-776-379. You can ask Patrick Allotey anything you want to ask him. And of course, the coach himself too is here. So get interactive. So call now, as we're talking. Yes, coach, you can.
So I saw him from the time he started training. It happened to me that.
Coach, that's why I didn't want to open the lines earlier. Anyway, there's a caller. Caller, your name and where you're reaching us from?
My name is
Razan. Okay, hello, caller. Your name, where you're reaching us from? Project a bit.
My name is Daniel.
Okay, Daniel, let's hear you.
I'm speaking from
Daniel, kindly lower your TV sets. Just listen to the phone and just talk to us, please. And project a bit. Okay, we have to catch you, Daniel, because we can't really hear you. Yes, coach.
So his attitude, the way he does his training, everything is part of how I come out to call him
poison. Or his nose arrow. Coach, you are a very experienced coach. You're going to this battle against Mexicans who are okay, so I'm told we have a caller. Caller, your name and where you're reaching us from?
Yeah, I'm Lucas. I'm calling from Tashin.
Okay, talk to us.
Please, I want to talk to Patrick Allotey and I want to give him a little of advice. I'm also a now, what I want to say about Patrick Allotey is that he should always keep his guard. He should always keep his guard. That's what I want to tell him.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you.
Yes, coach, you can continue.
I think you were asking about Mexican.
Yes, Mexican fighters. Mm-hmm. And this Golden Boy, they are noted to be very notorious, as in they have a way of getting their boxers ready. And it's undeniable fact that they use certain tactics, both legal and illegal, though he's not liked it. But you're going to fight Maguey, who the last fight, many people thought that he lost. They are trying to use Patrick as it were, as a face-saving fight, meaning that there is an agenda. Coach, you go into a fight like this, how prepared are you for Patrick?
You see, boxing, for now, these kind of things are always there. That is why most of the times you say you have to go with your own judge. Going with your own judge doesn't mean that you are going to knock your opponent out, but you can put up a performance that there is nothing that they can do but raise your hand and make you a champion. I think Patrick Allotey has that ability. We went to
Sweden,
and he was fighting a boxer who is also at his own home ground, and they did the fight, and all of a sudden they saw their boxer being knocked out. They thought they are just going to take advantage of us, and I think we can.
I'm told we have a caller, so coach, not to catch you anyway. Caller, your name and where you're reaching us from?
Yeah, good morning.
Good morning, sir.
I will speak to you. Let me speak.
Okay, go ahead.
My friend is a friend.
Okay, Mpachoka, sir.
I'm a person who can say, boxing, fact, if you were here, I say, Ghana force, I'm Yana, I rock, what are you in? And you will make three Ghana force, you in, I am back now. The car all this and to come up, Papa say, oh, you were a box, oh, when you did your look around here, we'll grab you, and when you see radio, okay. If you say, make three Ghana force, you in, I am fire support, and Kyle, when you do any time to be here, you in, I am fire support, me and pipe up, and tire, she may give you say. I mean, I don't know about the type of Ghana.
We are coming, you know, we do
some say, and that's been what is going on all over the place because people will put in their money and promote fight. And when you come there, they will make sure that you find always a means to maintain or to keep the title. But all the same, too, people also go and then have their way. Mm. You go there and then you'll be able to defeat your opponent and come victorious. Our champions, those champions that we have, they did it. That's the way they had their titles. So Patrick Allotey also know about all these things. We know that we are the underdogs, and we are going there. He is the champion, and we are going for his title. And at his own home background, the day, as you said,
Mexican Independence
Independence Day, and they are going to make sure that that day will not be will not be a disgraceful day. So
because that's the headline,
they will put in all their effort. But sometimes it is also opportunity for the boxer also to make name, because if he's able to come out victorious, then it means it will be a memorable day, and even in the minds of the Mexicans. So he's going there and knows
Coach,
what
I'm told. I have a caller. I'm told the line is beeping and the messages are many. I hope I can read them. Anyway, so there's a caller. Caller, your name and where you're reaching us from, please. Yes.
Your name is Dorado Bruce.
Okay. And you're calling from?
Dorado Bruce, a kickboxer.
Okay. Okay.
Dorado.
Okay. Talk to us, Tenado. Talk to us.
It's my boy, it's my boy.
My regards, my regards.
You boga.
Yes. I was senior coach, Mr. Ofori Asare. I will mean the general one. I will the champion of the general.
Okay. Thank you. Because of time, we have to. So please,
pardon us. That guy is a kickboxer. He's a very good guy.
Oh, okay.
So with the with them. Yeah.
Yes, coach. You are about finishing your point before Samuel will come in.
So, Patrick, as I know him, is not scared. He's going there to put up a performance that will be memorable, and I think the end. We all need this victory because we have only one champion.
Currently.
We need to add up to it. Ghana is a great boxing nation. We are going through a lot of up and downs in this our boxing, and I think it will be an uplift if he's able to go there and then make that mark for us.
Okay, so LC Dansua says that I like this guy. I think he's a very handsome guy. And he should go and win for it and give him my number. LC, it's not my platform that you used to. Patrick is very. This one is saying, okay, Black Meteors, I'm not going to read Black Meteors' message. This one says, good day, champ. Ghanaians are solidly behind you, and we are keeping you in our prayers. Just bring out the best in you, and God will do the rest. No fears, champ. God is in control. God got to put Ghana on the world map. Okay, that's from Na De De Classic. I don't know if you know her. Yeah, I'm told I have a caller. Yes, caller, your name and where you're reaching us from.
Hello.
Yes, your name and where you're reaching us from, please.
Morning. Father, good morning.
Morning, sir. Morning. Your name.
I told you, Thor.
Okay. Okay. Ofane, go ahead.
Thor from Choco.
If you are the boss, I'll call a little bit proud. You are the man who is winning the owner. You can see people are chocolate beef, they must be fair. The girl who is very good, they must go to the top.
Okay, okay, thank you very much. Sami, I will let you shoot your question. I think I stopped coach, eh?
Yeah.
Okay.
Well, I think all said and done, we are ready. They are strained, as you know, a lot of people are expecting something big from him. But I think here I also take another opportunity to talk to him that you should keep calm, and because when you are going to such a big competition and you are very calm, you will be able to have the focus and then see through all the stress and difficulties that will come your way. So I know he's ready, but he has to also feel that he's ready, and then we go there and make the difference.
Wow. Sammy, before you come in, Micah Ashley is saying that, how do you put your show together? I just love your content. I think that you should be supported. Get in touch with me after the show. Okay, Micah Ashley, I will definitely get in touch with you. I don't know what it's about, but I'll get in touch with you. I have this one which says, my name is Tony Hones Agri from Nungwa. Please, guys, I like the guys in the studio and the discussions. God bless you and your family. God bless you too as well. Sammy, you are going to ask your question?
Yeah. David, if you, because the coach has been now fallen. I've not been seeing coach a lot, but once he's here, I have to ask this question. Before the African Games, are you up that we'll get about 5 medals in boxing? You also hope that we'll get about 3 medals in boxing, but we got only 1 bronze. Coach, what happened? I know that some of the bosses were cheated.
You've diverted,
but yeah, but we'll come back.
But coach,
yeah,
this is just 1 minute
yeah,
answer.
Yeah, 1 minute answer. Because of the African Games.
Mm. You know. Yeah, I think so many things happened to the boxers.
I'm told I have a caller. So caller, your name and where reaching me from?
Yes, okay. I'm Albert. Yes, calling from Choco.
Okay.
Ujo area, yes. I'm going to, what I need to tell my boxer, Patrick Allotey, is I know every positive effort is a helping hand. And I know how serious he is with his training and everything. Physically is there, and psychologically too, I know he's there. So I am so expectant that he's going to bring the title to Ghana. I wish him well.
Okay. Bye. Okay, okay. And Sammy, before you come, this one is saying, hi, I'm Harry from Tema. I'm disappointed in the Meteors. The Meteors did not win. I wish Patrick Allotey all the best from Tema. Okay, so you said Harry from Tema. And you mentioned about Kotoko will beat Hearts. They will not know their way home. And all that. Yeah, Sammy, I think Coach was answering.
I said that some factors affected our team in terms of some new changes of weight category.
Okay.
As well as because the boxers, some of them were fighting in a different weight category. You realize that Jesse Latif was 64, fighting 69.
I'm told the call, but let's pick us. They will beat us here. They don't understand why you are not picking the calls, Mr. Ampofo. They are telling me via messages that you are not picking their calls. But my producer tells me that we can't pick any more calls. No, the head of sports is here. He will use his discretion. What do you say? Some extension for like 10 minutes for
exactly.
Calls.
I do believe, you know, Ampofo should give it maybe some 10 more minutes to, you know, because Allotey is leaving.
Yeah. Yes, yeah. Tonight. This is exclusive.
Ampofo should not actually be telling him. You know,
yes, the head of sports has. Okay, so then let the calls come. I beg you. I'm getting. They say I'm not reading their message. I'm not picking their calls. Okay, I'm told I have a caller. Caller, your name and where you're reaching us from? Hello, caller.
Good morning.
Good morning, sir. Talk to me.
Good morning.
Good morning, sir. Your name and where you're reaching us from, and go ahead.
This is Miss Allotey.
Okay.
Charlie, the calling from Anya.
Hmm. Go ahead, sir.
Okay, my son, my
okay. Okay, go ahead. Go ahead. Okay, this guy is a staunch supporter of Isaac Dogbe. He says, like, I like this guy. Good morning, bro. Wishing my countryman all the best. Great show. I'm enjoying it. Keep it up. That's from Joshua Amano, inside Kasua Obom Road. Staunch Isaac Dogbe fan. Too bad. There's a news there. We don't want to talk about it anyway. There's a bad news for Dogbe, but we don't want to talk about it.
But Sammy,
it's an exclusive to us. We just don't want to talk about it.
Absolutely, absolutely. Yes. Sammy, I think if I'm just to sum up everything, actually, Allotey has all the support, support of Ghanaians, and I'm actually hoping to see him go in to make Ghana proud, of course, in boxing. You know, for the past times, what we've seen, apart from Kwame, all the rest we've seen.
I'm told there's a caller. Okay, so there's a caller from Old Ningo, yes. Your name? I can't speak at that, I beg you, please. We won't go in for English. Yes, go ahead.
You know,
In fact, so far, this has been my best submission. You know, all the gods of Adaningo are behind Patrick Allotey. So that ends it all.
Sammy, your question, few questions to Patrick, then we just wrap up.
So
I'm told there's another caller.
Maybe one more caller.
Maybe I'm told the lines are
on behalf of the GBA. You know the GBA
Communication
Director?
Yeah.
So on behalf of the GBA, Peter Zwenis and all the big
Okay, Sammy, we'll have to pick this call. Yes, caller, your name and where you're reaching us from.
Hello, good afternoon, sir.
Afternoon, sir. Hey, it's morning, oh.
What is that? Please, I'm Amanda Yao Albert from Mass City School.
Okay, go ahead, sir.
I think that guy is a serious guy. I personally trained him. He knew me, a power man. He's very dangerous. I like his physique is very, very good. So he should keep it on.
Okay.
I'm supporting him. I'm one of his fans.
Okay.
He should keep it on. He's very dangerous.
Thank you.
He's dangerous.
Because of time, we have to... Yeah. No, it has to be quick, I beg you.
So, on behalf of the GBA, we want to wish him all the best. And if you go with his own judge and referee, like the coach said, go with your own referee and judge and win the fight for Ghana. So, on behalf of the GBA, we wish you all the best. If you're on behalf of Friends of Boxing, we have another group called Friends of Boxing on Facebook. We also wish you all the best.
Patrick, would you say that you had a very good training camp going into this fight?
Yeah, very good. Yeah, very good training camp. Because, you know, Coach Asari behind. You don't want to lose.
Okay, so I'm sorry. My producer says we're not picking any more of your calls. So
talk about his training regime. Yeah. You went to the camp, the soldier training, to go do some military training to your boxing training.
Yes.
How did that want to add to your training? The military training and the boxing training.
Yeah, okay, that one, I'll leave that one to Coach to talk about.
Yes, of course.
I think it's a physical base, physical condition base.
Yeah. Okay.
That's the Kabik management brought that idea, and it's very good. Most of the times, we all know that when we talk about physical condition, it's about the soldiers, and they have that more. So going there also to tap that part of it is also very good. And then he has a boxing aspect also as well. So all inclusively, I think he has prepared. He has all-round kind of training, and when he goes there, that is the reason why he has to build his confidence, that he has passed through a lot of training programs, that he shouldn't let anybody down.
Coach, are we leaving tonight?
We are supposed to leave tonight, but there are certain things we are working on.
Okay.
If everything goes on well, then we'll know.
Okay.
So yes. One more thing that I want to tell you, that if you can really link up with Coach and other likes, if HSTV can really
can
show this
show its life.
I mean,
yeah, we have to talk to Ivan.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And so, hopefully coach as well. So that we can show it live for Ghanaians
but
to watch.
Let's not forget Buku Faku is fighting tonight.
So I mean it's key to my heart, you know, so that we can see how HSTV, you know, the lead way in boxing in Ghana, so we can actually see what to do.
It's true.
For
Ghanaians. Because HSTV showed the Cummings fight.
Yeah, Richard Cummings.
Have to show this one too.
And in fact, for all viewers, His Excellency Nana watched the fight.
Oh yes,
on HSTV.
Yes. On HSTV. We had that feedback. That's great. Even the former president as well.
Also watched it.
President Mahama, and I think that's a big achievement for HS Television.
Yes, you know, and
we very grateful to that. Some few final words to Patrick. Then,
I wish him all the best, and we should go and do it for Ghana, with your own jet. Like I said, like I was born, Nelson does it. You know, I don't want to say we go with his own jet and referee and win clean. There's no doubt. There's no controversy.
Patrick, I have two questions before we wrap up. My first question is, Maguire seems to have a lot of respect for you. He says you have a lot of experience and that you are not a fighter that he's underrating. First of all, how do you see him, Maguire, as a boxer? How do you see him? Because normally when boxers are going to fight another boxer, they have their own impression of the kind of boxer they're going to fight. How do you view him? What's your opinion of him?
Yeah, well, Maguire also is a very good boxer, and you know, that will make the fight tough a little bit. But, you know, like I said, I'm not scared of him. And we are going to do 12 rounds of boxing. So I'm okay.
Mm. Can you tell Ghanaians confidently that you're going to do your best and probably win?
Yeah, well, I can promise Ghanaians that the physique, I don't know how to say, I'm ready 100%. For this bout, because I also want to be a world champion. Yes,
that's the thing.
I also want to be a world champion, and I know I am the one who is going to be in the ring. But I would like to appeal on Ghanaians to support with their prayers, because without their prayers, I don't know what will happen. But I know with their prayers, everything will be successful. So what I'm trying to say is that they should help me with their prayers, and I think I'll also not let them down.
Okay. My producer is breathing down on my neck. Your message, I couldn't read all of them. But coach, your final words.
Yeah, I think we thank HSTV. We thank Kabi Promotion for getting us this far. We thank everybody who has been the fan of Patrick Allotey and in all ways supporting him. And we hope that as Ghanaians as they are, as boxing, they love boxing so much, and if we go there, they will follow up wherever it is, and they will also, you know, even before we come down, they will be able to have what happened there. So we thank them, and they are going to put up our best performance.
Did coach says they are going to put up their best. Some of your final words.
Oh, I want to thank everybody that this chance has come to Patrick Allotey. He has waited for this opportunity a long time. You know, he has fought for the small titles. WBO, WBC Silver, and Co.
He's the current African champion.
Yeah, WBO. What is the main one? WBO World Title. So as this chance has come, I think shooting fearless, you should go there and grab it by force. Grab it. Because it's yours. It's your chance. WBO is the guy on beating. Beat him and make a record. Beat him on the best candy and make a record. Thank you.
That would be something.
For me, it's a victory for Ghana boxing, and that is where my interest really lies, to see boxers moving forward, you know, to win titles for Ghana. And indeed, also kudos to the coaches and all that who are making the boxers feel. I always have passion for athletes, you know, first, you know, before anything. So seeing them moving forward this way is my passion. I'm so much happy they getting, you know, people to support them, Kabik and all that, you know, promoting them to, I mean, this higher height. So good luck, I mean, good luck to him, and we'll be monitoring him as well.
And I think they come to my support, the government.
The government.
Because, I don't know, when he comes, he's fighting the under the flag of Ghana. So the government has also have a packet for
you. Look into the camera and say your final words to Ghanaians and legends. Just 30 seconds.
Patrick Allotey, you know, next week by this time, I'm going to come out with the Kumida Kabi Promotions. wa ke amen chuma kwakwa na amen chuma agona HSTV ame bomodin wa ke program na na amen fi agona minda in coach Leonshi coach Asari Chasquote Frank Nameli many nyama prince many nyama cha me be fi minda ni finishin na you are done
and also thank you as well for tuning in. We are very much grateful. Of course, we'll see you same time next week because we've virtually spent all the time. So we are back same time next week. Have a great weekend. Bye for now.
See you
now.